Sitemaps are a way to show search engines all the content that's in a website, even pages that weren't indexed yet. Hello, I'm Kate, and I'm going to teach you how to set up your sitemap with Rank Math. Since this tutorial will use options from the plugin's advanced mode, before we begin, you should open Rank Math's dashboard and check if you're not using it in easy mode. If you are, just click on advanced mode in the upper right corner. Then, we can access the sitemap settings general tab, where you'll make decisions that impact the sitemaps you'll include later. On the top of the tab, you can see the link to the sitemap index. That's the one you'll submit to search engines at the end of the tutorial. Because the truth is, you won't create just one sitemap file. Each website can have multiple sitemaps, one for pages, another one for categories, or for each post type, etc. When you submit the sitemap index XML file, search engines will find all other sitemaps within that automatically. The following settings will impact all the sitemaps you create. We start with links per sitemap, that limits the amount of URLs in each page. Having more control over the number of links per sitemap benefits performance. Then, we see two options regarding images. The first, images in sitemaps, enables search engines to find the images more easily and index them to show up in image search results. On the other hand, include featured images does the same to those images that you add as the face of your posts, even when they don't appear in their published versions. Now that we're talking about posts, you can exclude specific ones by submitting their IDs. An ID is a number assigned to each page or post, and you'll find it in the URL when you open it in the editor. It's the number right after post equals. This applies to any post type you have in your website, including custom ones that you may have created. You can exclude tags, categories, and custom taxonomies in the exact same way with the setting Exclude Terms. To find their IDs, access that type of taxonomy and click on Edit for the one you want. It'll be the number right after ID equals. The last setting, Ping Search Engines, tells Rank Math to notify Google and Bing when you update a sitemap. After going through this tab, click on Save Changes. Now, we're going to see all of the sitemaps you can include in your website. Let's divide them into two types, content and taxonomies. Content sitemaps are for pages, posts, attachments, products, and, in case of forums, the forum pages, topics, and replies. In all of these, there are two options. The first option, Include in Sitemap, creates a sitemap for that type of content. The second, Image Custom Fields, is useful when you are adding images using custom fields instead of inserting them into your content the traditional way. If you want those images to be indexed like any other in the page, add the name of that custom field. Before we move on, there's a specific characteristic in attachments we need to explain. You might know that attachment in WordPress is a post type created for the files added to pages and posts. When it comes to indexing pages, attachments are considered to have thin content, because the only content in an attachment is the uploaded file. Rank Math's default is to direct search engines from attachment URLs to the pages, or posts, instead of indexing them. So if you want to add the attachment pages to the sitemap, first you would need to deactivate Redirect Attachments in the General Settings Links tab. Then, return to Attachments in Sitemap Settings and activate it. Alright, moving on to the second type of sitemaps, the taxonomy ones. These apply to categories, tags, and any custom taxonomies you create with a third-party plugin. They also include topic tags in forums and product categories and tags in e-commerce stores. They will always have two settings. First, if you want to turn that taxonomy's archives into a sitemap. For instance, your category sitemap would be a list of links to the archives of each category. If that's active, the second setting appears, a possibility to add even the ones that don't have any posts in them, which are called empty. After creating each sitemap, click on Save Changes at the bottom of the screen. Once you've created all the maps, check the index file in General Settings. In case you want to reset all sitemap options, return to the General Settings page and click on Reset Options. You will need to confirm, as this is irreversible and you will have to start all over again. If all is well, we can go to the last and most important step, submitting your sitemaps to search engines. Websites that already use the Google Search Console integration in Rank Math don't need this, because the plugin will submit the sitemap index file automatically. You can make that integration in the plugin's analytics section. If you prefer to submit sitemap files manually to Google Search Console, you need to have verified your website. In the Search Console's dashboard, click on Sitemaps in the index section of the sidebar. Enter your sitemap's URL and click on Submit. You don't need the full URL, just the section after the domain. To submit your sitemap to Bing, you also need to verify it. Bing allows you to just import your settings from Google Search Console, but you can also add the verification code in the Webmaster Tools tab of Rank Math's General Settings. Once your website is verified, Bing's dashboard will tell you to submit your sitemap, or you can click on Sitemaps in the bar to the left. Paste the sitemap's URL and click on Submit to confirm. The good news is that you only need to do this once if you activated the Bing search engines option. If this tutorial helped you, give it a like. If you have any questions, click on the link in the description to open a free support ticket. You can find more tutorials and videos in our knowledge base at rankmath.com/KB.